evening, ladies and gents, viewers and subscribers. This is your host, Elvin Martinez from the Immigrant Education Channel, the only channel that addresses real immigrant issues, coming to you with another informative video from the Bronx. But ladies and gents, the video tonight is going to be about the fact, due to an increase in violence or an uptick in violence by the Venezuelan migrants, the mayor of New York, ladies and gents, has decided to expand curfew to 21 other migrant shelters here in the five boroughs of New York, ladies and gents. The requirement of the curfew is that no migrant leave the assigned shelter system between the hours of 11 p.m. and the 6 a.m. Basically, ladies and gents, as I said, no migrants are supposed to leave or enter any of the assigned shelter system between the hours of 11 p.m. and 6 a.m., ladies and gents. So, ladies and gents, one of the reasons, as I said, that the curfew has been expanded to more than 21 migrant shelters is due to the increase in violence, specifically by Venezuelan migrants, especially after the assault on the NYPD officers in Times Square, and also the recent shooting at a sporting goods store in Times Square. That being said, ladies and gents, what I'm going to do at this moment is that I'm going to walk to the migrant shelter at 4006 3rd Avenue and 174th Street here in the Bathgate section of the Bronx, and just to see if there is any new update at this location. So, ladies and gents, the first curfew, all right, that was the initial curfew was implemented because of some of the migrants that were at the Roosevelt shelter. Basically, what happened was that the people that live around that shelter complained that they feel like their quality of life was changing due to the fact that some of the migrants were riding around on mopeds and creating all kind of disturbances around the neighborhood. The second reason, ladies and gents, why another curfew was implemented was due to the due to the assault on the NYPD officers. And the third reason was due to the recent shooting by a 19-year-old migrant in Times Square. So, ladies and gents, this shelter seems to be very, very crowded. It seems to be very crowded at this shelter. So, I'm gonna give you a view of the area. This is how the shelter is looking at the moment. This is 4006 Bardgate Avenue. So, let me just take a walk. Let me just get a better view of the area. So yes, ladies and gents, I'm at 4006 3rd Avenue here in the Bronx. So this is the scene outside the migrant shelter at this location. Yes, ladies and gents, viewers and subscribers, so according to Mayor Adams, one of the reasons for extending this curfew also is to safeguard the migrants and also the community around the migrant shelter. Yes, ladies and gents. So this is the situation here at 4006 3rd Avenue. Ladies and gents, so as I was saying, most of the crime are committed by the Venezuelan migrants, and that's based on reports from the NYPD. Ladies and gents, according to the NYPD, there's also a Venezuelan gang known as Tren de Agua, who is presently operating in New York at the moment. So yes, ladies and gents, so this is the view here outside the migrant intake center on 3rd Avenue. But this place seems to be used as a intake center now. What's up, brother? How you doing? Good night, good night. Thank you. Yes, ladies and gents, things seems to be getting worse as far as this migrant crisis. There seems to be no end to this situation. So yes, ladies and gents, as I stated, New York City has expanded curfew to 21 other migrant shelters due to the recent uptick or due to the recent crimes committed by predominantly Venezuelan migrants here in the Bronx. Yes, ladies and gents. That's the famous Wendy's right there, ladies and gents, that I had took like 2 migrants to have something to eat. Yes, ladies and gents, you're getting this exclusive view from the Immigrant Edification TV from 4006 Third Avenue here in Bronx, ladies and gents. Ladies and gents, for your information, the music that was playing, I have no rights to that music. Boss man, how you doing? You're good? Bless. Yes, sir. Yes, ladies and gents, this is the view from 4006 Third Avenue here in the Bronx, ladies and gents. So, ladies and gents, according to some migrants, they said that they have no issue with the implementation of the curfew as long as they are given time to come into the shelter after 11, specifically for those who do delivery. So ladies and gents, I'm at 4006 Third Avenue here in the Bronx, ladies and gents, and my reason for being out here is to, you know, let you know that a curfew, or the curfew, has been expanded to 21 more shelters And the reason for that is due to an uptick or an increase in violence by the Venezuelan migrants here in New York. So yes, ladies and gentlemen, according to the mandate, no migrant will be allowed to leave the shelter between the hours of 11 p.m. and the 6 a.m. in the morning, nor will they be allowed to enter the shelter system at that time. So yes, ladies and gents, as I said, right, in my previous video, right, most crimes, according to the NYPD, are being committed predominantly by Venezuelan migrants. And then the irony about that, ladies and gents, is that the Venezuelan migrants are the ones that get most of the perks. They are the ones that are being placed in five-star hotels. If you notice the demographic out here, is predominantly African migrants. And for the most, these brothers, right, if you're watching the news lately, these brothers seem to keep or stay away from problems, but they get the worst treatment. So as I said, from my experience, like going to the migrant reticketing center at St. Bridget's School in the East Village, it's usually predominantly African migrants that are out there. The Venezuelan migrants are the ones who are housed at such hotel as the Row NYC, the Roosevelt Hotel, and the other five-star hotel in the Midtown Manhattan area. And these are the guys that are committing most of the crimes. But then again, maybe it makes sense that they are the one who are committing most of the crime, because then they got all day to sleep. They are placed in five-star hotels. So, like the African migrants, they don't really have that privilege. These brothers do not have time to be thinking about committing crimes, because look where they at right now, right? They are at this facility, trying to see if they can even get a bed or somewhere to sleep for the night, while the migrants at the Roosevelt and Row NYC, they are comfortable as, I don't even want to use the word right now, ladies and gentlemen, but yeah. So based on my previous interaction with these migrants and my experience on a whole, I've observed that it's mostly African migrants that are at these rundown shelter system here in the Bronx. You might see maybe one or meet one or two Venezuelan, you know, but it's usually mostly African migrants.